Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Today we'll be putting new shocks, new rear struts on that Hyundai Elantra, guys. If you've driven one of those things, even if it's brand new out of the dealership, guys, you can check on the forums. It's super unstable in the rear end. When you hit a bump, the car tries to go everywhere. That's because they installed the wrong shocks on it from the factory. So what we're doing, we're installing KYB gas adjuster right here. So stay with us, guys, to see how to replace the shock on Hyundai Elantra, the generation from 2011 all the way until 2017. First thing that we need to do, okay, we will need to go ahead and break the lug nuts loose. Okay, and when you get them tight, guys, always use a torque wrench. Just barely get them loose so we can lift it up. Don't take them off now because the car is not in the air. Okay, two more to go, and we will also need to have the emergency brake on. And now we're going to install, it's a four-wheel drive car, so we'll put it on the rear left wheel because we'll be replacing the rear right, the car, the tire choker. Okay, right here, like that. Then next we need to find the lifting point of the vehicle. Okay, and jack the whole car up, that side that we're working on. Okay, and you will need to have a jack stand as well. Okay, we will let down to be on the jack stand. Okay, because we'll need the jack for something else. Okay, now we can go ahead and proceed with removing the lug nuts with a 21mm socket. Next, grab the wheel and put it face up under the vehicle. If it drops for some reason, if it follows the jack stand, it's going to fall on the wheel and not you. Better scratch the wheel than kill you, right? Okay, guys, and this is the shock right here, and you can see this one is even oily now, which means that it's not good anymore. So stay with us to see how easy to replace those things are. Alright, guys, we'll use some WD-40 penetrating spray, especially if you're exposed to more snow. Okay, so we're going to spray this one now. And there is one more right here on top, the second bolt, which is hard to get to. I'm going to show you. You can spray it as well. Okay, so now the bottom one, guys, is with a 19mm socket. Okay, so we're going to get it loose. Let me. We need to have the breaker bar here. And don't take it off. It's very important not to take it off yet. And I'll show you why, guys, because we need to support the spring so it doesn't shoot in your face when you remove the strut. Okay, let me switch it one more time. Okay, it's a little bit rusty here, so it's not going as easy. Okay, perfect. Now it's loose. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to get the jack and support it under the spring. Okay, like that, just to stay there. Next, we can go ahead and remove the bolt. Okay. It's actually a nut here. Okay, you can see this is the nut. We got it off. Okay, and this is the bolt, guys. Okay, you can just slide it out. It has a little bit of rust, so you can lubricate and grease it before you install it later. Next, we need to remove the second bolt for the strut, which is the one located right there. I don't know how tight that thing is, let me see. It's pretty tight. So what I'm going to do again, we'll get the breaker bar. Okay, and get this one loose. And remember, you need to spray this one on the back side as well. We already sprayed ours. Okay, came loose. Now we can go ahead and use a little impact. Okay, you can see how long that thing is. Okay, that's the top bolt, the one with the 17 millimeter socket on this side. Next, you can grab the strut, okay, the shock, and you can pull it out. It's a little bit stuck there. Okay. And it's out. You can see this is the strut. Really cheap made strut. Very disappointing. And this is the Japanese KYB strut, which is way better quality than this one. Stay with us and let's put it together now. Okay guys, we are going to use some Treadlock. We always apply some when we replace shocks because suspension can have some vibrations, and as a result the bolts might get loose, so we always apply a little bit of Treadlock. We're going to get the new strut now. Okay, you need to have the bolt ready. Okay, right here. And you can see, we'll go ahead, install the strut where it's supposed to be, right there. Okay, and now we need to go with the bolt through the strut. Okay, and don't get it tight all the way. Make sure you have about 5-6 revolutions hand tight. Okay, and after that we'll install the one on the bottom. Okay, right here. Okay, right now you can see we need to turn it, so you need to grab the shock and turn it with your hand, because it's not where it's supposed to be. Okay, and right now we need to go a little bit down on the jack, just a little bit, a hair down. Okay, so we can make sure that everything is leveled up. Okay, still go just a little bit down. Okay, like that. Next, you need to get that 19 millimeter nut and get this one tight as well. Okay, it's the one right here. And then we'll need to tighten the top bolt as well. Okay, the top one with 17 millimeter. Okay, we got this one tight. I'm gonna get the breaker bar and just get them a little bit more tight. Never ever trust just the impact. I'll get them to what they were before. Okay, perfect, this one here. And the one on the back now, which is on the bottom. Okay, we need to turn it. One more time. Okay. Next, we need to install the tire. Stay with us. Okay, next you can go ahead guys and install your wheel on. Okay, and we need to get the lug nuts installed, but Now we're going to show you how to properly torque them. You can find that in your manual on page 617. It needs to be 65 to 79 pounds per foot, right there. That's the torque. Okay, so that's what we'll be doing. I will just use the little impact so I don't turn them by hand all that time. Okay, and you need to go in a star looking pattern. Okay, a little bit here, there. Okay, next we're going to get the torque wrench. We have it set at 79. I usually go the maximum on it for safety. Okay, and you hear an audible click, okay, when it's ready. Okay, right there. Then we need to go here. And what I'll do, I'll go one more time to check all of them at the end. Okay, that's the whole procedure, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you guys next time.